Ole, member representing Akoko, South East South West Federal Constituency. I'm from Ondo State. I also want to join my colleagues in congratulating Mr. President for successfully putting this budget together and forwarding same to this House. I think it is our constitutional responsibility to ensure that we do the needful and eventually come out with a budget that will impact positively on the lives of our people. Mr. Speaker, I will limit my contribution to the debt component, the borrowing component of the budget, particularly the 1.2 trillion that will be sourced from the from domestic market. Mr. Speaker, to me, progressive increase in our debt profile will not help us as a nation. I'm not in support of huge amounts of borrowing to service the budget. I keep asking this question that how will this impact positively on our economy? That is it capable of providing jobs to the unemployed Nigerian outside there? And what becomes of our small and medium-scale businesses? We are all aware of the attitudes of our banks in Nigeria, that they always prefer to give loans to the government, while the small and medium-scale businesses are made to suffer. They are being stiffened financially and eventually strangulated. And it is all, we are all aware that the bulk of employment comes from these small and medium-scale businesses. To me, this will not grow our economy. There's need for us to encourage the small and the medium-scale businesses and also ensure that funds are made available for them to grow. To me, Mr. Speaker, the 30% allocated to capital to me is too small, while the about 70% that is allocated to recurrent expenditure is on the high side. We must grow the real sector, which is the manufacturing agricultural sector, so that more jobs can be provided, and so that at the end of the day, Nigerians can be better for it. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Okay, thank you very much. And the question is, the bill be now read a second time. Those in favor of the motion say aye.
Aye.
Those against it say nay. Ayes have it. Clerk is invited to read the long title of the bill.
Honorable Speaker, honorable members, a bill for an act to authorize the issue from the Consolidated Revenue Fund of the Federation, the total sum of 7,298,507,709,937 naira only, of which 419,020,648,000 naira only is for statutory transfers, 1,663,885,430,499 naira only is for debt service, 177,460,296,707 naira only is for sinking fund for maturing bonds, 2,979,151,756,196 naira only is for recurrent non-debt expenditure, while the sum of 2,058,989,578,536 naira only is for contribution to the development fund for capital expenditure, exclusive of capital expenditure statutory transfer for the year ending on 31st December 2017. Second reading.
The bill is referred to Committee on Appropriations with all other standing committees and subcommittees of the Committee on Appropriations. Honorable colleagues, I plead.